hope you can fit in that wall. This is Hole in the Wall. This 2000s game show aired for a single season on Fox in 2008 and would be later picked up by the Cartoon Network in 2012. Now, if you have not heard of the show, you have to have at least seen it. The show is based on a Japanese game show that translates to Brain Wall in English. The show has been a simple concept. Fit through that hole in the wall, make it through, good. Don't make it through, well, that's bad. Now in the two versions of this game, it played out the exact same except for the bonus round. So each episode, two teams deemed their spandex suits would be made up of three people with similar interests. Now before the first round would start, each team would select a team captain for the episode. That team captain is immediately thrust out in the playing area as a 13 by 7.5 foot piece of styrofoam with a giant hole in the wall approaches them.
Shorty gets into position, raises his leg. Oh! Shorty's in the pool! Not clear. Let's look at the replay. Look at this. Shorty actually takes flight for a minute here. It's like he defied gravity.
That team captain must conform his or her body to fit the shape that is coming towards them. If they're able to stay in the playing area and make it through without breaking the wall or falling into the pool behind them, they would score a point for that round. In round two, the remaining two members of the team were led out on that playing area. This time it would be a double wall, which means that both players must pass through the wall in order to score for the team. If only one member makes it through, no point was awarded in the Fox version. However, in the Cartoon Network version, if a player made it through the wall, they would get a point. Even if one made it through and the other one didn't, they would still score. In round three, the team captain would come out in the playing area and join the pair. All three players would attempt the triple wall. Same as before, all players would have to make it through the wall to get some points.
Score these points. Remember to stay within the play area. Make the shape. Are you ready?
You got it, bro. This is for wrestlers the world over, baby.
All right, backyard bozos. It's time to face the hole.
Go.
Okay, three guys for just one hole. Close to making the correct shape.
Teams would then advance to round four, the speed wall. All three team members would have a chance to challenge the wall. But this time, if anyone makes it through the wall, they would get 2 points, for a maximum of 6 points. However, if all three players would make it through the wall, they would get a $5,000 bonus. But in the Cartoon Network revival version, the speed wall only involved the two players from round two. However, in addition to speed, the team captain would then spin their teammates in order to make them dizzy. Once the wall was revealed, they would run off the course and the spin teammates must regain their composure and make it through that wall. Later, Cartoon Network would change it up again and replace it with a spinning portion with a prop. The two players would have to make it through the wall with their prop. But also in the Cartoon Network version, they just didn't give out $5,000 for making it through this wall. Now in the Fox version, if both teams were tied at the end of the main game, they would both compete in the bonus round. However, in the Cartoon Network version, they would compete in a tiebreaker wall. Now the bonus round did vary between the two versions. We'll talk about the Fox version first. In Fox's bonus round, a blind wall would take place. Yikes. One team member will be blindfolded in the playing area. The two remaining players would then stand behind the pool that is behind the players, guiding them into the correct position to fit to the wall. Now for this round, the audience is instructed to stay quiet for the round so there is no interference that is aimed towards the team. If they succeed, they would win $100,000. Now remember what I said before about the Fox version. If there was a tie, both teams would compete in the bonus round. In that situation, both teams would have a chance at $50,000, half of the normal prize. Now let's move it over to the Cartoon Network version. All three team members would then compete in the Impossible Wall. In this wall, the team was tasked with doing something in addition of making it through the wall. Now some examples are fitting a giant jigsaw piece through the wall, or trying to hold on to slippery balloons as the wall came towards them. If they made it through the wall and completed the task, the team would win a spot on the Wall of Fame. They would then recreate the bonus wall with the confetti shot. And something else to mention, Cartoon Network uploaded a round on their website called The Killer Question that did not air on television. Based on the British version, teams would have to pick one of two answers and move to that side of the wall to make it through. The wrong answer would just be a plain wall, knocking them into the water, and the side that had the correct answer would have that hole in the wall. Now, Hole in the Wall was one of those crazy shows that were coming out at the time, at the turn of the decade. But it proved that anything could be a game show. And you didn't have to be some sort of unique, smart human being in order to win a game show. And what we have learned from this show is that whatever game shows they come up with in Japan is sure to cause lots of laughs and entertainment. Once again, thanks for watching another video from my channel. If you like that video, make sure to press a like and subscribe for more content. Ring that bell so you never miss any time I upload. And until next time, this has been Reality TV History. I'll see you later.